What's up, YouTube? It's your boy Deshaun checking in once again, and I'm back again with another video, man. All right, y'all already know how it go, man. If you're new to the channel, you're feeling the vibes, comment down below, hit that bell, and subscribe. Yes, sir. All right, so real quick, I just want to point this little error message out that you guys are seeing on your screen. For those of y'all who've been wanting some modding help and all that good stuff and some custom clothing, I have this error message on my computer not allowing me to open up certain programs. So I've looked at YouTube videos, I've researched, everything that everybody else does work, but everything that I do just don't work. I don't know. So I probably followed like 6 YouTube videos. If y'all got some info on this, y'all comment down below and let me know. But I did order a hard drive, an external hard drive, to get everything I want out, because my last step is to completely factory reset this PC. You know what I'm saying? And that's the last step before I go buy another PC or build another PC. So y'all just bear with me. Y'all might see this pop up while we are recording, but like I said, just bear with me, because I'm still not trying to let this get in the way of me bringing y'all this flavor. All right, so anyway, today I'm going to be showing you guys how to do your own stash houses. That's right, this might be a doozy, so this ain't the video that you just, okay, I got it, boom, let me click, nothing, I'm saying, let me click off and go ahead and jump in and do it. You got to pay attention to this whole video. If you want it done right, you got to watch the whole freaking video. All right, so let's jump right into it. All right. What we want to do is we want to come up here to our search bar, and we want to type in show, C-O-O-R-D, because we're looking for show coordinates, man, bro. I'm just going to type in C-O-O-R-D. There we go. Show coordinates. You got to know how to coordinate. R.I.P. Pops, man. But this is what we're looking for, and this mod is coming to us by Liberty Locked. Show coordinates right here. This is the mod that you need in order to make your own stash houses. And you can do a lot more with it, too. You know what I'm saying? You can do a whole lot more with it, but we're going to be using it to make our stash houses, okay? So let's come right here to the current. We're going to hit download. Boom, boom, boom. Alright, so I'm going to come and open up my downloads folder. I did download it some time ago, but it's going to say show, well, it's going to say right here, cord recorder. Alright, once you open that file, it should be 2 little files in here. It's going to say cordrecorder.cs and cordrecorder.ini. Alright, so that's pretty much what it is right there. So what we're going to do is open up our main GTA directory, just like so. Let me open that up a little bit more so it look natural to y'all, you know what I'm saying? Get up here, son. Alright, once we got our main GTA 5 directory open, we want to open up our scripts folder. And this video is brought to you by the Wendy's Breakfast Baconator. Comment down below if you had the Wendy's Breakfast Baconator. When I tell you that is not a breakfast sandwich, that is like a piece of life. Like, I think Wendy's killed the entire breakfast sandwich scene with the Breakfast Baconator. Go to Wendy's, get that number 7 with some orange juice. It's gonna change your life. I promise you, it's not no biscuit. It ain't no damn croissant. Matter of fact, y'all hear that? I got one right here. Stop playing with me. Anyway, we're gonna open up. All right. So let me start up. We're gonna take these 2 little files right here. That breakfast bacon had to do it to you every time. Boy, I got off track. We're gonna take these 2 files. Simply drag them up here and drop them in our scripts folder. I'm not gonna replace them because I already got them. But if you don't got them, go ahead and do it. And that's it. So, we're not done with this video yet. Now we have to go into the game, and I have to show you guys how to record your coordinates for the stash house. Then we have to come back out of the game and we got to do some work. All right. So y'all ready? Stay tuned. All right, guys, real quick before we jump into the game and do this, I just want to show y'all right here in your scripts folder, the cohortrecorder.ini with the little gear right here. This is where you click to change your function keys. So by default, in the enable key to enable the mod is F9 and the save key is F10. You can leave it as is, but for me, I normally have my enable key at F3, which I probably definitely need to change because that's the same one as simple trainer. And my save key, I normally have it as F2. But I'm probably gonna go into the game and see which F keys don't do anything, and I'm gonna change it to those. But I just wanted to show you guys that so you could take this opportunity to save it to whatever you want it to be, or you can roll how you want to roll until this tutorial is over. Choice is up to you, but hey, let's get right back to it. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are back into the game. And I got to start saying ladies and gentlemen because all of my female subscribers, I'm pretty sure if I keep saying guys, they're going to catch me at the Shell gas station one day and beat my So, yeah, man. Ladies and gentlemen, y'all welcome. So, as y'all can see, I did download Single Player Apartments just to experiment to see if I can turn some of those houses into stash houses. This particular model right here worked perfectly fine for me. My closet, if you do this one, now this is very important, so y'all just please pay attention. If you walk up to this, like let's say for example, I walk up here, it's supposed to say change your clothes. It don't say it right now. But anyway, this side normally says change your clothes. So I didn't put the stash on this side of the closet. I put it on this side of the closet so I don't interfere with the clothes, because you got to push the same button to open the stash. So I put the stash here. Stash is functional. I got, boy, $100 million. Goodness gracious. And all that's off of work. Look at all this work I got to help, man. Come on. Y'all ain't pumping like me, bro. Look at that. I got 20 bands in my pocket. I can, come on now. Anyway, it does work. Stash does work. My health pack does work. It's right there. Who are you and why are you in my house? Oh, I think she's one of my dealers or a bodyguard or something. She got a blue, anyway, let's step outside for a second. So this is the entrance right here. This is the entrance for the single player. You don't want to put those close to each other. Kind of separate them, if you will. It all will make sense shortly. So what we're going to do is we are going to go find another spot to turn into a stash spot. So let's take the Gucci dome. The Gucci dome. It's not getting a copyright. Radio off. All right. So guys, we are about to go find another place to do to turn into a stash spot. I tell you what, why don't we go into town? Let's go into town. We have a ton of single player apartments, but I want to use this example for. Okay, let's just do this. Let's do this. Let's find somewhere to go here. All right, I've already turned Franklin's auntie's house into a stash house, but let me show you guys something. So as you can see, I put the entrance to the stash house on the side. If you first come into the game and you walk directly through the front door, 9 times out of 10, your stash won't be visible, just like that. It will not show. Don't panic, be like, yo, it don't work, I'm done. Let me message 16 people before trying stuff on my own. Nah, don't do that. You gotta, in order to become good at modding, you have to explore your options, right? So the stash is right here in the fireplace, but it's not showing, correct? because I walked directly through the front door. Girl, go home, because I walked directly through the front door. What you're going to have to do, even if you put your stash entrance at the front of the house, do not just walk through the door. I've had maybe 18 people say, hey, man, the stash ain't working. Did you walk through the door, or did you just, or did you stop at the door and enter the stash spot? No, I just walked through the door. Okay, well, that's why it's not working. So I'm going to come here, enter through the stash house, and somehow that activates the stash. Now you see the stash is working and it's visible. So, guys, it's important and imperative to pay attention. Like, got to go through the stash. Got to go through the stash entrance, not walk through the front door. Now you see the stash is visible. I got 28 million in this one. I got more work in this one than I do in my other one. I'm a fool with it. All right? So, that's a very important part of this whole situation right here, man. Go through your stash entrance. Do not just walk through the front door. If you walk through the front door 9 times out of 10, it will not work, okay? I mean, it'll still work. You just gotta walk through the stash to activate it. Now, stashing 101. All right. Let's say we want to create a stash spot for one of these apartments over here, right? Watch out, boy. Let's say we wanted to make this apartment right here a stash spot. Well, we've never been inside this apartment. We don't even know if this apartment has interior. So a quick way to do that is to open your spooner by pressing. Now, you have to have menu to do what I'm about to do. So by pushing F9, that puts that little cross right here. And you just kind of push yourself through the front door to see if you can see inside. If you do this, you see nothing. Nothing's going on. 9 times out of 10. If you do make this a stash house, you cannot. You will open the door and fall all the way down to the through the abyss. This is what underneath GTA looks like. But I'm going to tap F9 to go out of there. So, you want to make sure the house has interior, okay? Shut the hell up. Girl, handle my lightweight. Get him. Get him. Get him. Oh, she fired, bro. Nah, don't even get in. Anyway, I'm gonna go somewhere where I know it has interior. What haven't I made a stash house already? Let's take, for example, Trevor's house. Where's Trevor's house? That's the airport. We can make Trevor's house a stash house because we know Trevor's house has interior. It's in the game, for crying out loud. Any house you've seen in the game, Michael's house, Wade's cousin's house, any house you've seen inside of GTA can be a stash house. Where is Trevor's house? Over here. So we can definitely make Trevor's house a stash house. Even though we cannot go inside of it, we don't have access, I'm going to hit F9 and boom. You see that? It has interior. It has roaches. Damn, do we want to make this a stash house? All right, we're going to use this as an example. That's all we're going to do. We're going to do this as an example, okay? Okay. I can't believe I'm finna do this. All right. We finna walk into this Roach Motel. Alright, so fresh off the boat, fresh from the download, F9 activates your coordinates, and it'll push the wrong thing. And it shall pop up just like this. You see up here at the top now, when you walk, it records your coordinates. And F10 saves it. I went into the INI. And I changed, so F9 to activate, F10 to save. I changed my activate button to F3, and I changed my save button to F2. You can change it to whichever function key you want, but I'm probably going to recommend changing it to something that does not already have something else tied into it. Like, for example, when I push F3 to deactivate or activate, that's the same exact button as my simple training. So I just hit B to close out the simple training, and cool. But I really should just put it on a function key where nothing else is tied in with that. But anyway, once we have our coordinates on, and you see it at the top of your screen, you want to walk up to the front door. Just get right up on it. Flush up on it. Alright, if you're following this video and you haven't changed the function key, you're going to hit F10 to save. I'm going to hit F2 to save, okay, because I changed mine. Anyway, we're going to save, and you'll see this. Enter a name for these coordinates. This is the one, this part you really need to pay attention to. Can't stress it. Pay attention. This is Trevor's house, so we're going to put Trevor. And this is very important that you label this stuff. Trevor. Then you want to put entrance. Or you can put enter. But I got Trevor space entrance. Then we're going to hit enter. That's saved. Alright, we saved that. Cool. Now we're going to hit F9 or RB if you're playing with Xbox controller. RB and right on the D-pad. That brings up this little plus. What we want to do is kind of move it until we have that plus lit up green on Franklin. Then I'm going to hold the left trigger. Where did she come from? I'm going to hold the left trigger so I can move Franklin around. What I'm going to do is push Franklin through the trailer. Alright, I pushed him slightly through the trailer. Now I'm going to let left trigger go. That puts him inside of the house. Okay? Get off the wall, bro. Now that I'm inside the house, I want to walk up to the same door. And this is going to be my exit. So once I'm all the way up to the door again, the same door I'm going to, you know, go in and out of, I'm going to record again by hitting F2. You're going to hit F10 until you change your function key. So let's go ahead and save that. We're going to name that Trevor space exit and enter. So now I have my exit save. I mean my enter save. I have my exit save. Two more things you need to save. We need to save our stash spot and we need to save our health pack. If you notice, every stash pot has a health pack. Your health pack is, you know, let's say you get into a shootout, you run into your stash spot. That's your safe haven for the time being. If you shot up, you want to go ahead and juice your health back up, get right, you know what I'm saying? So that's the purpose of that. My goodness, I would never use this as a stash house. But anyway, let's find out where we're going to stash at. So should we stash in the refrigerator? Should we stash in the stove? Or should we come back in stash in this raggedy-ass closet? I'm going to say the closet because who else? If you walk through that front door, you ain't even going to want to come in here, man. So we're going to stash right here in the closet. So we're going to walk right up to the closet. Hit our record button. And we're going to name it Trevor. Space. Stash. Now, the reason why we're naming this Trevor, simply because this is Trevor's house, and we don't want to get mixed up, because I have a lot of coordinates. I have coordinates for the beach house. I have coordinates for Mike's house, Franklin's auntie house, and I just want to keep it organized, okay? Last but not least, where are we going to put our health pack? Let's put it right here on the couch. Now, your health pack will kind of, it'll kind of be up in the air where you're sitting. I have a sit down on anything mod. See that? So what I'm going to do is turn around, try to get up on the couch. I guess I can't. Okay, well, I was going to try to get on the couch and sit down so that way my health pack will look like it's sitting on the couch, but oh well. She out there shooting at somebody. Yep. Where she at? Yeah, just shooting at somebody. Anyway, that ain't none of my business. I'm just going to put the health pack right here. So we're going to record. We're going to name it Trevor. health. Enter. Now, we have everything we need. We have our entrance, we have our exit, we have our stash, and we have our health. Now, I'm going to hit F9. Grab Franklin. Franklin, where are you? Once I got Franklin, I'm going to hold the left trigger button and push him outside again. Sit him down. F9 again. And where the hell? Oh, about to say, where my card? Dang, they shot it up, bro. Now, once I've done that, I'm going to save. I'm going to do a quick save. I open it up my phone. Going right here to quick save. And boom. The only reason I'm doing a quick save is so when I come back into the game, I'll be right here and not way across town and have to teleport back here again. So, let's go ahead and exit out of the game. Now, once we're out of the game, this is part two. This is the tough part. If you cross-eyed, you probably won't be able to do this. Once you go back into your scripts folder, and I'll just, you know, open up your main GTA 5 directory, open up scripts. And now, first we put in coordrecorder.cs and coordrecorder.ini. Now we have a third one now, coordrecorder_coord.txt. We have that now. This is where our recordings go. So if you double click here, you'll see that I have tons of entrances already. The one we just did was for Trevor. So I'm going to come underneath this one, hit enter to, you know, keep them spaced out. You know, I have Mike's entrance coordinates, Frank, Auntie House, the Beach House. What is NF? See, I should have just put the whole name because now I don't even know what that is. That's the whole point of me having y'all to label this stuff. I remember Beach, but NF. I don't remember what NF was. The Boons, that's for the Boondocks, the Boonies, way out there in the country. But, what is NF? I don't freaking remember. See, I should have labeled the whole thing. Anyway, this is Trevor stuff. So we're going to put that here. Now, we're going to open up our LS Life folder right here. Click, click. Then we're going to come down to our stashhouses.xml. We're going to right click and hit edit. Okay. Now, what you want to do is come to this first one. It's labeled, instead of being labeled 1, 2, 3, it's labeled 0, 1, 2. Okay. So, we're going to come right here to house ID 0. This is the one up the street from Franklin's grandma, Franklin's auntie house. And what we want to be do, what we're going to do is we're going to change the XYZ coordinates for the entrance. So this is entrance position, XYZ, and this ends the entrance position. So we're going to be changing the XYZ coordinates in the entrance position. We're going to be changing the XYZ coordinates in the exit position. That's the second one we recorded. We're going to be changing the XYZ coordinates in the stash position. And we're going to be changing the XYZ coordinates in the health position. That's it. Once you've done this, you've created your stash house. I want you guys to start right here at 0. So, I'm going to show you guys how this goes, okay? Under house ID equals 0. You're going to come right under entrance position. So the X, everything inside, the numbers only, okay? Do not highlight this right here, the greater lesser sign. Do not highlight the whole joint. Only highlight the numbers here. We're only changing the numbers. Only the numbers. For example, even if it has... I'm going to show you for an example. Even if it has a negative sign in front of it, like this one has a minus sign, get the minus. Get the minus and all the numbers. That's it. If you mess up on this, this is the most critical part. If you mess up on this, your stash house will not work. This is not the video to just rush through, all right? So just take your time. So let's go. I'm going to change Trevor's entrance. Let me see. Okay, so I'm not gonna do house ID zero. You're gonna do house ID zero, okay? So you stay right here. I'm about to scroll down. Do not do what I'm doing. Don't do what I'm doing real quick, because I want to keep this one. I'm gonna scroll down. Y'all do not scroll with me. Stay right there where y'all at. I just gotta do something real quick. This is the end of house ID zero, and then house ID one starts a new house. XYZ coordinates. Then house ID two, that's your third house, 012. I've added a fourth house. Okay, so there's my fourth house. 0123. So that's four. This is number four, so that's actually five. And now I'm gonna add Trevor's house, which is a sixth one. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna come to house ID four. I'm gonna copy everything all the way down to house. Right click. I'm gonna copy. This is for y'all when y'all get a little more advanced with it. After you copy, you come right here to the end. Click. You're gonna hit enter. Then you're gonna right click. And you're gonna hit paste. Just like we do when we're doing the add-on car. Then we're gonna go back up. You see the house ID is four. That's the one we just copied. So if we go up some more, we should see another four. So we want to change the one we just added to five. You got to keep the numbers going up. So we got zero. We got one, two, three, four, and five. I'm changing this to five. All right. So I'm going to do this one. You guys make sure you're under house ID zero. Do what I do. But make sure you're doing it under house ID zero, okay? If this is your first time. So, you guys being under house ID zero, me being under house ID five, this is my sixth one. What we're gonna do is make sure we are under entrance position, okay? And we're gonna come down here to Trevor entrance. We're gonna highlight just the numbers only under the X. Right click, copy. Then we're gonna come up here to house ID zero. Mine say five, yours should say zero. Under entrance position, X right here. We are going to highlight the numbers only inside of the greater lesser sign. Right click and paste. Now, 1973.505 should match 1973.505 here. Next, we're gonna do the Y position. Numbers only. Right click, copy. Come under here to the entrance position under Y, highlight the numbers only, right click and paste. 3815.409, 3815.409. Next, the Z position. Highlight numbers only, right click, copy. Under the entrance under Z, numbers only, right click and paste. 33.425, 33.425. That is it for the entrance position. We have an entrance. Now, let's go to the exit position. Okay? Trevor exit position. Highlight. Right click. Copy. Exit position. X. Numbers only. Right click and paste. 1973.147, 1973.147. Y position. Right click, copy, exit, Y position. If it's got a negative, get that negative too. Right click and paste. Okay, numbers match up. Next, Z position for the exit. Right click, copy. Make sure you're in the exit. Now, let me tell you what I did. I was going and I'm look, you know, and I'm looking at this light. Let me paste that. 33.429. And I realized I was going fine. Then next thing you know, I was putting like the exit on the stash and this and here. And I just messed it all up. And then when I went in, so if you don't pay attention to what you're doing here, make sure you put every exit X on. You got to pay attention now. All right, we are on the stash. Trevor stash. Numbers only. Right click. Copy. Stash position. Right click and paste. 1969. Cool. Y position. Copy. Y position. Paste. 38. Boom, boom, boom. Perfect. Z. Copy. Stash. Z. And paste. Last but not least, our health position for our health pack. Health X. Copy. Come up here to health X. Health position. Numbers only. Right click and paste. Y position. Boom. Copy. Health position. Click and paste. Z. Right click. Copy. And once we get that last one, and remember, get if it's got a negative in front of it, you get that too. You highlight that too. It's going to say the lesser sign, Z, greater sign, everything in between that. Okay? Right click and paste. We have just successfully, if you following me and you where I am, you just did your very first stash spot. So, I have 1, 2, 3, 4. I got stash houses, man. So, and if y'all need coordinates, hit me up. Now, once everybody get up to speed, I want everybody in my Discord to try stuff. See what I'm saying? Try certain single player apartments. See if they work. If they work, post them coordinates in the Discord. Help everybody out. You know what I'm saying? We gonna basically do that. Now, make sure you hit save when you exit out of the recorder. And for Stash House, if you just exit out, it's going to ask you, do you want to save? You can hit save there, or you can hit file and save there. Either way it goes, make sure you save. If you don't save, don't be crying in Discord now. You pay attention to what you're doing now. Don't be crying. Save it first. Then you exit. All right, let's jump back in the game. And we're going to check out our stash spot, guys. So, y'all hang tight. All right, guys. We are back in the game. I started back right here because I did a quick save right back here. So, as y'all can see automatically on the map, Trevor's house now has a greenhouse blip by it, signifying that that is our stash spot. And I'm walking up on the porch, and I do see the green blip. So once I walk into it, it should say press enter. Press that to enter stash house. We're going to enter stash house. Once we are inside, I see the stash right here by the closet. 100 million. What it looks like it does is because it after the third stash house, it kind of repeats. So my first stash house and my fourth stash house should be the same stash house, just in different locations, because I see I have 100 million in here in the same amount of work that I have in my first stash house. So, hey, that's cool. Our health pack, just like I said, is in midair because we were standing up when we did it. So, just walk into it, boom, bump it on the floor. It's cool. And that's pretty much it, guys. We just successfully made our first stash house. Now, I don't see a marker right here at the door, but if you walk up to it, it should still say, press that to exit stash house. So that's pretty much how you do it, guys. If you followed everything, you just successfully created yourself a stash house. Now, I want to point one thing out to you guys before I get off of here. First thing I'm going to do is back that up so we can get some daylight. Second thing I'm going to do is teleport. I'm going to teleport to where I'm teleporting at. Over here. Because I want to show you guys something before I get off of here. Now, computer. Anyway. I've tried twice to make the penthouse a stash house. I'm going to show you what happens. Now, the penthouse didn't work for me. I have an entrance at the front door. I also have an entrance inside of the garage, right? I tried the top one. I have not tried anything under the top penthouse towers. Maybe the towers apartments will work, but the penthouses, I've tried it twice and it didn't work for me. So what I want all of my mod squad to do, now that you guys know how to do this, experiment a little bit, man. Like I said, see what single player apartments work at stash houses. See what, you know what I'm saying? Like, see what other things, you know, see what works. As I walk over here, I see my stash spot is not even there no more. So my entrance to my stash house was right over there in the corner. So I'm going to use this instead. If you ever see that, my stash isn't here, or the entrance isn't there, but I can push myself through the house, do that first, because sometimes you have to activate one of the stash markers in order for everything to work. This is not something that's perfect. We are actually manipulating the files. So you cannot expect this to be perfect. You understand what I'm saying? You cannot expect it to be perfect. You can't say, hey, this isn't working right. You got to figure something out. You know what I'm saying? Because we're manipulating these files. You see what I'm saying? There's no guide that says if you do this, it will work perfectly or your money back. You know what I'm saying? So you can't just, you know what I'm saying, get upset, because, you know, you just got to keep trying stuff out. That's what makes us great as modders. I see right now that my stash isn't here. But like I said, the penthouse just does not work properly, man. It just doesn't. So I wouldn't recommend doing a penthouse. You can try with the other towers under single-player apartments. Try some of the houses down there on single-player apartments. Try what works. And if it does work, put it in the Discord, you know what I'm saying? And, we'll see what works. So that's going to help us kind of troubleshoot, and that's going to help everybody out. All right? We're going to have a list for stuff that don't work. We're going to have a list for stuff that do work. That's going to help everybody out. But, hey, I hope y'all enjoyed this video, because I'm about to be late for work. But like I said, I wanted to bring y'all this flavor. I didn't want to let this issue with my computer keep me from bringing y'all these videos. So I'm about to be late for work. I got to hurry up, put my clothes on, and shoot down there. But like I said, man, y'all keep subbing, keep liking, keep commenting, man. That helps me out. We are on that 600 sub grind. You understand what I'm saying? So, like I said, keep doing what y'all doing. I appreciate all of y'all, man. And, hey, let's start looking forward to that 600 subscriber giveaway. Let's start looking forward to it, because, boy, I got some stuff for y'all. Anybody say big-ass rim pack? Y'all want that big-ass rim pack and some more stuff? Let's hit that 600, bro. I'm out of here, y'all. Gone.